You are not an ordinary person. We are the outshining of God's glory. Don't let any circumstance have enough power to bother you. The Father has nowhere to stay than inside you and cannot express himself unless through your body. So your body becomes his body. That is why the Bible says we are the body of Christ. Shout it. Say, I'm a doer of the word.
I'm a
world shaker. I live by the word. I'm born by the word. We are here to produce heaven on this earth. I produce heaven on earth. Zadiva Kasi. For whatsoever is born of God overcomes the world. And this is the victory. That's why I say, don't give up. Hey! Moko seki paravuka du setivaha. Zagu. Rebege de Vezia. Vege. Yakusa tifaroski parakataya. Ah, I feel like turning water into wine.
Pastor Brent. Worth hearing.
2021 is our year of all grace. Yay!
Oh, I am, I give to you, Lord. Say,
all I have, I give to you, Lord.
Oh, I have, I give to you, Lord. Say,
Second Corinthians chapter 9, verse 8. Are we there? Second Corinthians chapter 9, verse 8. Oh, tekos pradis kopolo. Say the sincerity of my love.
The sincerity of my love.
Malatos kopondo sepelegedesh. Is that not powerful?
It's powerful.
It says, and God is able to make all grace abound toward you, that you always having all sufficiency in all things may abound to every good work. Is that not powerful?
It's powerful.
And God is able to make all grace abound toward you. Who is able to make?
God.
Now, will God make all grace abound toward the person who doesn't love him? No. Yes, and God is able to make all grace abound toward you, that you always having all sufficiency in all things may abound to every good work. If you have the New Living Translation, NIV, just get it for me. Amen.
Amen.
But you see, and God is able to make all grace. Say all grace.
All grace.
Now listen to me. There are different kinds of graces in the Bible. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Are you here?
Yes, sir.
By the time I finish, you understand where I'm taking you to. Amen.
Amen.
Then we are somewhere in Koforidua, we are going. And God is able to make all grace abound toward you, that you, always having all sufficiency. This is one of the most, if you understand this scripture, and you lie down, and you wake up, you'll be shocked at yourself for being the way you are. Come on, shout glory.
Glory.
And God is able to make all grace abound toward me, that ye having all, you always having all sufficiency in all things may abound unto every good work. Now listen to me. Are you listening?
Yes, sir.
There are different kinds of grace displayed or showed in the Bible. Different kinds. Amen.
Amen.
This time it talks about all grace. There's the grace to give, the giving grace. There's the ministerial grace to minister like I'm doing. Amen.
Amen.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
There's a grace that is obtained during salvation. Amen.
Amen.
So there are different kinds of grace. And the scripture shows us how to obtain grace or more grace. But I won't take you to that today. Amen.
Amen.
Maybe Sunday I'll teach you on that. I'll teach you on grace. How many of you know I've taught on grace before? Amen.
Amen.
So it says God is able to make all grace. Now, let me explain this thing. It's very powerful. God is able to make all grace abound toward a person. There is all grace. This is one of the scriptures that it talks about all grace. One scripture says that they which receive abundance of grace and of the gift of righteousness. So when you get born again and you are saved, you receive what we call abundance of grace and the gift of righteousness. Amen.
Amen.
One scripture says he giveth more grace to the humble. Amen. Then in this particular verse, he talks about all grace. So there is a place for all grace. But you see, it is not for everybody who is a Christian. There is more grace for the humble Christian. He giveth more grace to the humble. So you're a Christian and you're humble. You know how to submit to authority. You know how to submit to the word. You know how to submit to your pastor. Amen. You know how to submit to governmental authority within the church. He gives you more grace. But you see, more grace and abundance of grace. Then he says that, let us come boldly to the throne of grace, that we may find grace. For what? To help. So there's a time you need some kind of help. Something has happened to you, Alabasoto. And you can't stand. In fact, you are rolling on the floor. Then you receive grace to stand. Come on, shout glory.
Glory.
Or sometimes you are going through something, you are not coming out, and you are just going through. And you feel like giving up. And there is this unusual grace that comes upon you to keep you there so that you don't give up. Grace to help. It's a helping grace.
Helping grace.
Shout glory.
Glory.
But you see here, he talks about all grace. So God wants us to walk in all grace also. Who wants to walk in all grace? Now let me show you why. It says God is able to make all grace abound. The word to make there also means that God is able to abound grace toward you. The same word he uses for to make is the same word he uses for abound here. And uses for abound again here. Amen.
Amen.
So God has the ability to make all grace abound toward you. Then it says, so that ye always having all sufficiency in all things may abound to every good work. So why does God give all grace? So that you can do what? Always have all sufficiency in all things. And why do you need all sufficiency in all things? So that you can abound unto every good work. Listen, who has the NIV or New Living Translation? Now, listen to me very carefully. Are you here?
Yes,
sir. The word, you see, grace is a very powerful word. Amen.
Amen.
Many preachers don't know that there's a difference between grace and favor. Grace is not favor. Am I teaching you something?
Yes, sir.
There's a big difference between grace and favor. When you are a student of the Bible, you discover that nobody in there, there is nowhere in the New Testament Paul mentions favor. Do you hear what I'm saying?
Yes, Master.
Oh, it's only Obed who heard it. Maybe because you don't want to hear it again. Should we close and go home?
Master.
In the New Testament, you see grace. Grace. Some of you have seen great grace in the New Testament. But you don't see favor in the New Testament. But you see favor in the Old Testament. Can I show you why?
Yes, sir.
I will show you today. When you say it, I will show you. Amen. But you see, the reason why he uses the word sufficient, you see, this is powerful. Don't miss it. Say, don't miss it. Don't miss it. All grace for sufficiency. Now, the word sufficiency he uses, let me give you that word. Amen. It's very powerful. Say, it's very powerful.
Very powerful.
It means the word he uses for sufficiency means a perfect condition of life in which no aid or support is needed.
Amen.
Listen very carefully. A perfect condition of life. That's the Greek word he uses. That's the meaning. That's the word sufficiency. That's what it means. A perfect condition of life in which you do not require an aid or a help in anything. That means that once you climb to the level of all grace, then you have your experience. Oh, you are not here. You've gone on break. Can you guys ring the bell so that they come back from break? Awesome siren. Come on, shout glory. So that means that when all grace is granted Pastor Obed, then it means that that all grace causes him to walk in a particular kind of life where he does not require a help or an aid. That means that whatsoever he is doing in works, and whatsoever, he doesn't need a partner. He doesn't need what? In his business. In fact, that business, whatsoever he needs in that business will come. So it is not every Christian that is working in all grace. Some are working, are still working in the abundance of grace. Because they are at that level. Amen.
Amen.
Some are still receiving more grace by being humble. But it says, God is able to make all grace abound to me so that I can live in a perfect or have a perfect condition of life where I do not require any aid or any help. Is that not powerful?
It's powerful.
Then it says, when I enter into this area, then I abound to every good work. That means that there is no call for any money you can't give. Take us to any New Living Translation. Let me read the scripture there. I want you to understand what God means here. Who is hearing what I'm saying? Who wants to enter that kind of, who wants to experience that kind of? Well, you want to experience it, eh?
Yes, sir.
Who has the New Living Translation or NIV or something? New Living, give it to us. Mm-hmm. Just read it for us. Ko ati sabaha. Verse 8. And God will generously provide all you need. And then you will always have what? Everything you need. And plenty left over to share with others. So when all grace is on a particular person, Kabosta, this year all grace must come on somebody here.
Yeah.
Just one person is enough. You have leftovers. Did he say that?
Yes,
that's New Living Translation. NIV. Cash otokupa satire. You see, and that is why this is very important. Now, you say, man of God, this is powerful. Oh, I want this all grace. Is that not true? you are like the guy who went to Peter and said that, Peter, I want this kind of thing you people are doing. And gave money to Peter. So bring a seed, I'll show you. But listen, God is able to make all grace abound toward you, that you always having all suffering. 2021, I must experience this. How do you want to experience something? Some of us, we don't want to experience anything. We just want to be walking through life. Walking through life. Oh, walking through life. Kalaba Sotoya. Is that not powerful?
Powerful.
Who is hearing what I'm saying? Who understands what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Those at the back, are you hearing what I'm saying? Steph, you are catching something there. So saying, God is able to make all grace abound toward me. That me, always having all sufficiency in all things, will always be able to give. So this scripture puts you above calculating resources. Is that not true?
Yes, sir.
Some of you are calculating things. You forget about budgeting when you enter here. Is that not powerful? Since my assets are incalculable. Come on, shout powerful.
Powerful.
Is this scripture not powerful?
Powerful?
Let's think about it and see. Knowing that it's possible. But you see, all grace only comes through the grace of giving. So there is a giving grace. When you understand how to put to work a giving grace, then you receive all grace. Write that one down before you forget. That is the key I'm giving you.
Pastor Prince will be right back.
Let your praises fill our mouths. Let each vessel offer up to you a sacrifice of praise. You alone are holy.
Receive that glory. Receive that glory. I see the power of God. I see the power of God.
I just held where the gun, the bullets went, and I said, I am bulletproof.
They put my name in a national newspaper in Portugal. So
after Papa prayed for me, I got a response for one. And then they gave me the PhD scholarship. They'll pay my tuition, which are about £17,000 sterling. A lot of money. And they were giving me stipend.
Lord, you alone are worthy. You deserve the glory. Lord Jesus, Jesus.
Experience the moments.
Welcome back.
All grace only comes through the grace of giving. So there is a giving grace. When you understand how to put to work a giving grace, then you receive all grace. Write that one down before you forget. That is the key I'm giving you. 2021, if you enter all grace, you will have 10 hospitals in different regions.
Amen.
But if you stay at more grace and abundance of grace and all those graces, Maleko Sotoya, you'll be sitting down like this, say, Papa, Kala Usta. Is that not true?
It's
so it's happening, say it's happening live.
Amen.
This is when he says, when the Lord turned the captivity of Zion, we were like them that dreamed. Are these things true or are there stories man of God is telling me? Is that not true?
True,
sometimes you read and understand some scripture and walk around and say, are these things true? Ah, Lakuska. It says, for we have not believed cunningly devised fables. Amen.
Amen.
So this is all grace. But you see, what is very important I wanted to catch before we close is this. The all grace only comes when you get to know and understand how to appropriate the grace of giving. You hear what I said? So there is what we call the grace of giving. Now take us to 2 Corinthians chapter 8. I want to show you something there. Say, show us, man of God.
Show us, man of God.
Normally, when we talk about giving, what comes to people's mind is just giving your substance. Malakatos kipa. Let me show you something before. Are we there? 2 Corinthians. Can you do it fast for us? Or you are enjoying the message. You don't want to. You don't want us to go home. Come on, shout glory.
Glory.
Since we have seen strange things today. Sometimes you read the scriptures and you see that you are seeing strange things. The one who doesn't understand the scripture always sees men as trees. So when he says, pray for the blind man, he says, can you see? He says, I see men as trees. That's the life of many Christians. They're only seeing men as trees. When they see a man, they see the man's head down and the leg up. That's how they are seeing life. May this, your eyes of your understanding be opened.
Amen.
Kabosta. Shout glory.
Glory.
So I said what? 2 Corinthians chapter what? Chapter 8, verse 1 to 5. Amen. Is that not powerful?
It's powerful.
So, many Christians don't understand the place or the role of grace. That is why we are always after favor, 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 favor. Favor means, or when favor is at work, it means that you are receiving something that you do not deserve. So you see favor in the Old Testament because all that happened to them, all the things that God gave them and all that, they did not deserve. I think I've talked a lot about the Old Testament people and all that. Amen.
Amen.
But you see, when grace is at work, it has nothing to do with what you deserve or what you do not deserve. So many preachers just think grace means unmerited favor. Is that not true? Come on, shout glory.
Glory.
Amen.
Amen.
And if you are new here, you've not heard my grace message, but this time your head is going like this. Let me leave your head to be shaking. Amen.
Amen.
Is that not powerful?
It's powerful, sir.
But you see, when grace is at work, what is required to accomplish much is grace. What is required to accomplish much is grace. What is required for you to move from this level to that higher level you want is grace. It's grace. Grace means the outworkings of the Spirit. That's how simple I can put it for you. Is that not true? That's grace. It has nothing to do with you deserving or not deserving, because when you get born again and you are united with Christ, there is nothing you do not deserve. Before you get born again, when you get something, you do not deserve. But when you get born again, the reason why many preachers preach grace like that is because they don't know the Christian. Do you hear what I'm saying?
Yes.
The Christian is the one who is one with Christ. That's why he's called Christian. It means that he's in unison with Christ. He's one with Christ. So whatsoever comes into the hands of the Christian is not what he deserves or he does not deserve. What comes into his hands is what Christ has. What belongs to Christ belongs to the Christian. Are you following what I'm saying? And it is what belongs to Christ and the Christian that is manifested in the hands of the Christian. So it has nothing to do with whether the Christian deserves it or not. No Christian does not deserve something. It is the unbeliever who does not deserve. Can you say God deserves or does not deserve something? You say, am I God? But you are a child of God. So if you are a child of God and you are born of God, you cannot say that what God has, when it's given to you, you do not deserve. If I give my phone to my child, say, I do not deserve. He deserves it. You don't understand Christianity. So in Christianity, we are so one with Christ, that the scripture says, for as he is, so are we in this world. Is that powerful?
It's powerful.
So when you I wish I had time to open some kind of scriptures that will get you confused. In John chapter 17, when Jesus was praying, he said a lot of things. He said that which you have given unto me, I have also given to them. God has so much given us all the things he wants to give us, to the point where even his name has been given to us. Who heard what I just said there? So you see, people still have this feeling that we are humans trying to receive something from God. But in the revelation of Paul to the church, in the epistles that we see, he doesn't portray us as people who are just some human beings trying to receive something from God, who and we do not deserve it. That is what we call religion in the Old Testament. It's called what?
Religion.
Religion. So if you ever did religious studies, you will see that you were taught that you were what? You are trying to reach out to a supreme being. Is that true or false?
Yeah.
In Christianity, through Christ Jesus, we have become one with that supreme being.
Hallelujah.
You didn't hear what I said?
Hallelujah.
Who heard what I said?
Hallelujah.
So when you understand Christianity from that angle, your revelation of grace changes. Do you hear what I'm saying?
Yes, Pastor.
So I've explained this thing before. Maybe some of you. So it is, has nothing, grace has nothing to do with what? Whether I deserve or I don't deserve. Grace is the workings, outworkings, or the workings of God according to his purpose. So he looks at Pastor Obed and sees that Pastor Obed is matured enough to handle this. Then the Holy Spirit works it out for him or gives it to him because he's matured enough to handle it. Did you hear what I said? So it is not like, shout glory.
Glory.
Maybe you let me teach on grace right now. I won't teach again. Say, man of God, continue. It says, moreover, maybe Sunday I'll teach you something on grace. Is that not powerful?
Yes.
Should we do it like that?
Yes, sir.
Will you sow a seed for that?
Yes, sir.
What is the seed? Moreover, brethren, we do. Come on, shout powerful, man of God.
Powerful.
Who heard what I just explained just briefly about grace? Just briefly. It's very simple. Is it very simple? A lot of scriptures are in my mind. So I'm trying to sieve some and take some and put, but let's read this one. Moreover, brethren, we do you with of the grace of God bestowed on the churches of Macedonia. So there was a grace that was bestowed on the churches of Macedonia. Is that not powerful?
No.
Continue. How that in a great trial of affliction, the abundance of their joy and their deep poverty abounded unto the riches of their liberality. These are all big, big English. Look for NIV for us, a New Living Translation. Go to verse 3. For to their power I bear record, yea, and beyond their power they were willing of themselves. Verse 4. I said something. I said you can only, all grace can only, God can make all grace to abound toward you. When you understand the grace of giving. Did I say that? So you write that one and underline it. Very important. Praying us with much entreaty that we would receive the gift and take upon us the fellowship of the ministry and of the saints. Give me a New Living Translation. How's this English? Let me break it down to be about 3 a.m. Go to verse 5. Go to verse 5. Is that powerful? So this, and this they did, not as we hoped, but first gave their own selves to the Lord and unto us by the will of God. So when I talk about the grace of giving, I'm not just talking about material giving. I'm talking about here, verse 5. It says, they first gave themselves to the Lord. So it means that, are you following me? It means that all grace can abound to the Christian who gives himself. They first gave them. So in givings, there's the giving of your substance, there's the giving of yourself. Now, if you give your substance without giving yourself, that giving is still useless. That is why you say, I've paid my tithes for 22 years and I don't see results. You've not given yourself.
We know you have been blessed by this message. We would like to invite you to make Jesus Christ the Lord of your life by saying this prayer. Say, O Lord God, I believe with all my heart in Jesus Christ, Son of the living God. I believe He died for me and God raised Him from the dead. I believe He is alive today. I confess with my mouth that Jesus Christ is the Lord of my life from this day. Through Him and in His name, I have eternal life. I am born again. Thank you, Lord, for saving my soul. I'm now a child of God. Congratulations, you are now a child of God. If you've said this prayer, kindly send a message or call the following numbers now showing on your screen.
Get more messages of Pastor Prince on our social media handles.
Join us for our Sunday services every Sunday morning, 9:30 a.m. at Airport West Hotel, Accra. You are blessed.